as award-winning certified installers of SolarEdge technology. Here at Solar Plants, we have produced this video to help identify and resolve issues with your SolarEdge monitoring portal. If you have been alerted to an issue by our monitoring department, please don't worry too much, as even though your computer, tablet, or smartphone may show a communication alert, or it looks like your panels are no longer producing energy, it is very likely there is just an issue with the Wi-Fi connection and your panels are still generating plenty of free electricity for you to use. The easiest way to confirm your panels are still producing energy is to take a look at your generation meter in daylight hours. This will be located next to your fuse board. If your meter is flashing, then your system is producing usable energy. So please keep on watching and we will guide you through the process to reconnect your monitoring. If there is no red light, then please do not hesitate to contact us on 0800 856 2200. If your generation meter is flashing, but your monitoring portal is not recording your generation, please follow these simple steps to resolve your monitoring issues. The first step is to log into your SolarEdge monitoring portal and check the last date it was updated. If you are using a desktop or laptop computer, the place to view the last update is on your home screen. This is on the right-hand side under Site Summary. If you are using the SolarEdge app on a tablet or smartphone, you can see the date and time of the last update at the bottom of the picture in the home screen. If this date is around the time of a change that has been made to your Wi-Fi, for example, a password change, new provider, or new router, then you can follow our simple instructions in just a minute to help you reconnect. If there has been no change to your internet service, please go to your router and simply turn it off for 30 seconds and then turn it back on again. You will be surprised how often this little trick works. Fortunately, your inverter stores 28 days worth of data. So over the course of 20 minutes to 1 hour, your system should be back online, complete with historic data for you to view. If you find this has not resolved the issue, the next step will be to locate your AC isolator switch. You will have two AC isolator switches, one by your fuse board and one by your inverter. Please choose the easiest switch for you to operate. Turn the switch to off for a few seconds, then switch back on again. Please then check to see if your communication issue has been resolved. If not, please call us on 0800 856 2200. If you have changed your internet provider, Wi-Fi password, or router recently, I will now show you how to link your inverter to your home Wi-Fi. Firstly, you need to identify which SolarEdge inverter model you have had installed. There are two options, the HD Wave or the earlier generation models. This depends on when you had your installation. Let's start with the earlier models. Please locate the on-off switch under the inverter and switch the inverter to off. Press and hold down the LCD button for between 5 and 8 seconds. When you then release, the menu will be displayed. Using the LCD button again, use short presses to scroll down to the communication submenu and long press to select it. Using the short presses, scroll down to the Wi-Fi comp submenu, select WPS mode, and the status message should read waiting. Please now go to your wireless router and locate its WPS button. Push and hold it down until an LED light appears. If your router does not have this facility, please refer to the router manual. Please now go back to your inverter. The message should have changed to connected on the display. Be aware this may take up to 30 seconds. Once you have done this, please exit your setup mode by scrolling down and selecting exit. Please then switch the inverter back on using the on-off button. Your system is now connected again and will resume sending data to your monitoring portal. Yet again, if there are any problems, please contact us on 0800 856 2200. Now, let's move on to the HD Wave Inverter. Instead of buttons, you will have sensors. Please be aware they are very sensitive, so take care when operating. Please get your Wi-Fi password to hand, as you will require this during the process. Firstly, please turn off the inverter using the red button underneath. Using the buttons on the front, please press the OK button once. This will light up the screen. Next, hold the same OK button for 4 to 5 seconds. You will then be asked for a password. This is the password. Up arrow, down arrow, OK. Up arrow, down arrow, OK. Up arrow, and then down arrow. Using the down arrow, scroll down to the communication submenu and select it. Next, scroll down to the Wi-Fi configuration and press OK. Scroll down to the scan networks and press OK. Then scroll down to your home network and press OK. Again, using up and down arrows, you will need to input your Wi-Fi password by selecting the correct letter or number. You will need to press OK after each selection. Once you have selected the last digit of your password, hold the OK button for 2 seconds to finish the entry. The inverter should now connect to your home Wi-Fi network. Be aware this may take a few minutes. When your inverter display says connected, please press the escape button, which will take you back to the main screen. Please ensure that SOK is displayed, which indicates communication to the SolarEdge inverter. This can take between 3 to 5 minutes. Please then switch the inverter on again using the main red switch, which is located underneath the inverter. On behalf of everyone here at SolarPlants, we hope this video has been helpful for you. If you are a SolarPlants customer and you still require further technical support, then please contact us on 0800 856 2200. If you are not a SolarPlants customer and are still experiencing technical issues with your SolarEdge system, please contact your original installer or the SolarEdge helpline on 0800 028 1183.